Kingwest Resources. This morning's Ed Turner. Ed, good morning.
Yeah, Andrew.
A nice update from you here. Kicking off diamond drilling at Sir Laurence. This is clearly a milestone for Kingwest.
Yeah, long-awaited commencement of diamond drilling at Sir Laurence. It's the first diamond drilling actually on the lake within our tenement, so there hasn't been any previous drilling besides air core drilling. So we've had to get a customised rig in, a much lighter rig than the previous rigs, which can get bogged in the centre of the lake because it's just, that's the nature of the lake. So Raglan Drilling from Kalgoorlie has custom built this rig basically for us. And now we've commenced drilling and we're very excited about the potential of proving up the primary mineralisation within the bedrock underlying the lake. And that rig is on site and we have it for as long as we want. You can see from the footage that it's quite isolated and a long way from shore. So you do need the right gear to do this test work. And this rig is capable of drilling to about 400 metres downhole. And it's important to get that depth, to get the lateral coverage as well from a cross strike.
Tell us a bit more, Ed. What's the objective here? What are you looking to achieve from the diamond drill program?
Yeah, so we've had three air core programs so far, two last year, and where we discovered the gold. Once again, this was a totally new discovery, and one round of drilling this year. Now we've proven that there's mineralisation at Sir Laurence over at least 2 kilometres of strike length and 1 kilometre across strike. We've got a lot of prospective targets within there. So we're spoiled for choice about where we put the diamond rig. So initially, yeah, we want to just prove up the primary controls of the mineralisation in the bedrock. So basically, orientation of quartz veins, we expect them to be hosting the gold at depth. So we're starting in the centre of the deposit around line 5, which was the discovery line, and we'll work outwards from there. Once we figure out the orientation of the mineralisation, then we can step out in different directions. We know we've got bedrock mineralisation to the north and to the south and to the east and the west, and it's still open. So the program has to be adapted as we go, as we learn more about the nature of the mineralisation. But yeah, we've planned an initial 4,000 metre program. But if we have any success, we'll just keep on drilling.
And Ed, you've had some results back from the air core drilling on the nickel sulfide targets, just the gold assays so far.
Yeah, so it's the first program on the east part of the lake targeting the Highway Ultramafic, which is a fertile nickel sulfide package of ultramafic rocks, which extends over about 11 kilometres within our tenements. It's shown in the purple outline within the image. We did 14 traverses, basically, lines of drill holes across the Highway Ultramafic. We extended some of those lines also to target some lithostructural settings, which we consider to be prospective for gold. We've only got back the gold assay so far, and we can see significant mineralisation on 6 lines. So we're very happy with that, and including, 4 metres at 1.3, 4 metres at 1.2 within bedrock and at quite shallow depths. So that's highly encouraging. We'll have to go back and do more follow-up drilling there. Now, we're still waiting for all the nickel assays. They'll come in over the next few weeks. But so far, all the indications are good, and we're hitting the respective rocks in the right location. So there's a lot of exciting potential there as well.
Good to get an update. Ed, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.